Hi everyone, my name is Peter Atkinson.
And I'm Cammie Marup Stewart.
And today we're here to talk to you about yarning. So Cammie, what do you know about yarning?
Well, yarnings are a bit of a way that blackfellas can have a conversation with each other that may be a little bit different to the way whitefellas have conversations.
Yeah. I know when I think about yarning, I know that it's something that I've always known about. It's always seemed to be around in our communities.
Yeah.
And it's something that that we practice pretty easily, and it's just a way of talking, but on a deeper level.
Yeah, it definitely is on a deeper level. I think yarning is about building a relationship and establishing trust with each other before you ever get to any kind of just information sharing.
Yeah.
So it's really about knowing who you are and knowing who the other person is before you get to any sensitive topics or anything.
Yeah, it's true. And in terms of our culture, do you see yarning as a cultural practice?
Yeah, I definitely do. I think it makes sure that the way we're talking with other people, depending on who they are, we're using the right kind of protocols.
Yeah.
We're respecting people's positions in communities and respecting their expertise on different issues as well.
Yeah, that's so true. And I remember when thinking about how we were going to talk about yarning and thinking about examples of when we practice it differently.
Yeah.
And I know when we're yarning with elders, for example, that we do that with a different level of respect.
Yeah.
And where we let them guide the conversation, we let them lead us in the conversation, because we sort of know that we have to be extra respectful
yeah.
with elders, because they're going to take that opportunity to share knowledge or wisdom or information with
yeah.
us.
Yeah, and it's really a valuable way of prioritising knowledge that's been gained through generations and generations, and that's
yeah.
how our mobs pass on information. It's all oral kind of knowledge,
yeah.
and being able to respect how that information is passed on really makes sure that knowledge stays intact.
Yeah, that's true.
Mm.
And I know another way that we practice yarning is when we do it in a group.
Yeah.
I mean, it's really good to sit and have these yarns, but I really like that sort of group yarning, and I like it because you can take and say a topic that somebody's talking about and build on it when you're yarning.
Yeah, for sure. And it's a really great way of learning from other people, learning from their situations and experiences
yeah.
and being able to apply it to yourself in your own experience. So it helps in a whole range of things. It helps people who are talking about their relationships, or people who are talking about their health, or people who are talking about their jobs.
That's true. And I think in terms of culture and yarning, I mean, we're such diverse groups of people across
yeah.
the country, Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people, but yarning seems to be the one thing that we sort of all have in common.
It totally is.
Yeah, and it is something that we all practice in our own ways, and like you said, that there, in particular communities, there will be
yep.
different rules or protocols about how
yeah.
you practice yarning.
Yeah, so there's a lot of differences with different mobs. Some have traditions where you can't communicate directly with certain people in that community. So maybe a man and a woman can't directly engage in conversation,
yeah.
or maybe a mother-in-law and a son-in-law
yeah.
can't talk at all.
Yeah, yeah.
And those kinds of rules are definitely there for a reason.
Yeah.
And I think the one thing that yarning has in common across the country is that it really values those relationships over any kind of just everyday chit chat
yeah.
kind of thing.
Yeah.
So there is definitely some differences, and there's things that even blackfellas don't know about in other
yeah.
communities. So we've got to be careful and make sure we're respectful. And if we don't know what the rules are, then we've got to ask somebody that does know
yeah.
So that we don't stuff up and,
yeah.
and make any mistakes.
Yeah, that's true. And in terms of the benefits of yarning, what were you thinking?
I think, especially in a health context, yarning gives the opportunity to build those relationships and, more importantly, build trust between two people. So it means that if somebody, say a practitioner, a healthcare practitioner, wants to establish a relationship where the patient trusts the practitioner's guidance, then they really got to work on building that relationship first. And yarning is a really good way to do that. It's often much more informal. It takes a lot of the clinical out of the conversation, and it sets it up so that it's a mutual benefit. So it's not the clinician having the authority and the power. You're both on the same level, and, and you're trying to work together to come to a better situation.
Yeah, and I suppose that the yarning isn't, you know, it's different in that it's not just about getting information.
And that's it. I think the one key aspect of yarning across all mobs in Australia is that it values relationships first. That's the important thing. The information is important, but it comes second.
By practicing yarning, that builds the relationship, that builds the trust. You'll get more than information from the patient, and then that will then lead to better health outcomes. Okay, thank you everybody.
Thanks guys.
Bye.